only companies. Probably they'll be very far and few. In case there'll be a few. Probably something around at least 30 companies. Maybe you might find which are listed only on NSE and are not on BSE. So that sheet somewhere, sometime else we can probably put through. But majority of it will be covered here. Everything. Currently, this sheet is organized by market cap. Drop down, the descending order, that is how it is. Now, the same sheet is on the second, which is YTD 1, 2, 3 year. Now, I haven't done anything except one part. I have put a filter there wherein 1 year, 2 year, 3 year and YTD returns are positive. Wherever there are positive. So, out of around 3,100 companies, only 1,130 or so are positive companies. This just, you can use this sheet for any purpose you want. Just as a safe side, I have provided the same raw data sheet, which you can use, whichever way you want it. Free to use is there. You can filter, cut by whichever side you want to take, market cap, by if you want to track company, you want to look at companies which are down a lot from 52-week highs and all that, please feel free to do. Returns are there only for you to check it up in there. The next sheet that is there, this is also, the first parts are all same, which is company, sector, industry, all till PE is same. After that, what it is the returns are month-wise. November, October, September, August, July, June, May, April. I have covered all this full year month-wise. And I have given one-year returns. And I have given returns since March 23rd, 2020. This should be able to, you should be able to see based on this, how much the company, how much the stocks have moved from their 23rd lows, March 23rd. I assume March 23rd is a low. So that's why I've taken it. So March 23rd low till now, what is the return that you've got on it? Now, the reason why I put this data all the time for many reasons is that there are many new people here who probably don't understand the whole lot of companies. If you are doing options, you will be exposed to only 180 companies which are there in the F&O section, options section. That's it. You would not be knowing other companies. So for that purpose, periodically, I try to put this sort of data so that you can have access to all the companies. You should know all the companies that are there in the stock market so that you can make better choices. That is for this purpose. And second thing is, once in a while, such data crunching helps you to see where what is. When you take different cuts and filters and then try to do it, you will understand, okay, this company has done this way. Because you might be under a misconception that, nahi, wo achha company hai, sahi karta hai, usme kuch galti nahi hai and all. But you might find the returns are like very poor, or it hasn't done anything at all, or its EPS is very poor, because you tend to normally not look at financials. You'll be looking only at price. Aap chart dekhte honge, chart nikal ke dekhte hai udhar ki isne isme 50% diya hai. But when you go to see the financials, which you normally don't see, you'll be surprised to find that the financials are very poor. That is the reason why I do this. Another reason why I do this is I want you to use that third sheet, raw data, free to use wala sheet, to see in a sector what are all the industries are there and what companies correspond to that industry. Because many a time people don't know which company falls under which category or which sector or which industry. For you to familiarize with, for this purpose only, I'll do that. So you can take a look at all these companies. You can decide how you want to go forward for it. This can probably help you a little, in making the next half of the year decisions. We are finished till September, basically, on financials. The TTM PE that you see, TTM EPS that you see is for the last four quarters. So let us say you have shortlisted five companies somewhere. You can then see simply, take the case of Reliance Industries. Reliance Industries TTM EPS is showing as 77.3. By the way, I have taken as much as possible, all consolidated only. Just let me just re-verify once on screener how much is Reliance showing. I don't want to make a mistake here. So, Reliance on a... Reliance. Where is Reliance? Quarterly. Ending up the list four. Nahi aata hoga na? I can't copy paste. Just give me a second. I'm just adding it. Okay, fine. So you can just check, you know, after shortlisting, you can check on screener actually, okay, kitna lena padega, how do you want to look at it? Simple way, you don't have to do all calculations to find out where this stock or how much EPS will go. I'll give you a shortcut method. This is just a thumb rule, nothing more. I don't know if I've already discussed this with you. You check the, one second, it comes up. Open, share the link for you here. Open screener. I've shared the link. Just open screener for Reliance, and then you just check what it is. The previous years, sorry, I'll give you a minute to open. If you check the previous year's EPS was 77.50 that is showing for Reliance. Right. Now, when you are doing what do you call a forward EPS estimation, there are many ways to do it, but just on a thumb rule basis. If you see, the previous year corresponds to March 2020 till March 2021. Now, as this year enters, entered in June, you have June result, you have September result. So you are going to add June and September to the previous four quarters and minus the June and September of previous earlier year's quarters. Are you understanding? Yes, no? It is rolling basis, right? TTM is rolling basis.
Yeah, right now.
So what you will see, if you go to quarterly results Reliance in that sheet, in the screener, you will see that the four quarters EPS stands at 20.67. Correct? December is 20.67. Right?
Yeah.
20.67, 20.86, 19.36, 21.58. So these four should correspond to the TTM EPS. That is how it should be. I have to just check. I think probably I might have taken, consolidated only, but just in case if there is correction, I think I took TTM EPS only, but I don't know, maybe if I made any mistake there. Just let me see. Lots of data I'm dealing with, so that's why.
Yeah, I think you are taking the TTM data. I think
taken correctly or not, but anyway, see, it doesn't matter. You can even disregard that one, but PEs and all are correct. They won't be different. Let me check the PE of Reliance. How much is the PE of Reliance showing here? 32.15. Huh, more or less correct. Utna hi dikha raha hai, so that is how it is. So what you can do is take the half yearly data right now that you have got 19. Which is what EPS. 19.36 plus 21.58. Correct, na? Last two quarters? Yes?
Yeah.
19.36 plus 21.58. Now, these two add up to 40.94. Now, if you look at the previous year's EPS, it was 77.50. So, if you subtract 40.94 minus 77.5, you should get 36.56. That means, if Reliance were to hit 36.56 rupees EPS in the next two quarters, it will meet its current, it will meet its previous year's EPS till now. Correct?
Yeah.
Right? Yes. Now, to this 36.55, let us say you expect Reliance to grow by 15%. Okay. To this 36.55, you expect Reliance to grow by 15%, let us say. That means you will want Reliance to hit an EPS of 42, something like that. You can look at it. So, like that, you can make estimations for the second half of the year. While the first half and the second half are not too symmetrical, for many reasons for many companies, the first half and second half are not symmetrical. What you can do is you can check the September, you can check the December and March quarters of previous years. What do you see? You see a 20.67 and 20.86, correct? So there itself, Reliance is able to make a 20.86. Reliance is able to make a 41.53 rupee EPS. So if you think 15% Reliance earnings growth is possibility, and that means you want it to hit a 42 rupee EPS next year, you can be rest assured it is in line. That is how you would think so. You can calculate that way, and if you want, you can put it here in the sheet, wherever you feel like, if you are really doing financials. In case you don't want to do financial, chalo, main ye sirf naapne ke liye lunga, but really I don't want to worry about PE or EPS, then there are other ways to do it. You look at the only the returns part. Okay, open the second sheet which is there, which is YTD, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year old. Uskan. These are 1134 filtered stocks which have given positive returns in YTD, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. Now, in the shorter time frame, there are some negatives and all that you see. That's why I've highlighted in pink color. You can see that. If you want to base it on a market cap cut, that means these large companies, for example, top 100, have given positive returns in all the previous years, but in the last 6 month or a 3 month or a 1 month period, they're negative. So I would want to invest in them. You know, investments short term swing, jo bhi hai, tumne jo karna hai. Then you can look down at it. How do you look at from that sense? Look at column I, down from 52 week high. You filter by that and then pick whatever you want. If you right now, if you filter the same sheet, what you will find, the first thing you will probably come across is GTL Infra. Hai ki nahi? No changes, just filtering down by I. Correct?
Yeah.
Yes, first is GTL Infra, next is DigiSpice. Aa raha hai na?
Yeah.
And now, you don't want to put these small companies also. Then you filter by next F. F pe se filter mane number filter use karke, whichever market cap you feel like. Okay, you want 10,000 crore market cap at least, then take 10,000 crore market cap and then filter and see. The first company that you will get is Adani Power. If you put 10,000 crore market cap as filter. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
This way, any way, whichever way you want, you can take n number of cuts with this data. You don't want to consider the short term returns. You want to consider only long term intake. Then the sheet is useful. No, I want to consider every possible data. Then you can try on the other, the third sheet, which is there, raw data, free to use. Wala, aap kuch bhi kar sakte ho. Nahi, mujhe pata karna hai ki pichle 6 mahine mein kaise kiya ye company ne. Then you use the sheet one, which is there. So every month you check all those 6 months from April to November, whichever companies have given only positive returns, you want to take that and check it out. Then you do that. So all this data is available with you. So whichever cut you want to take. Nahin, mujhe March 23rd low se jo bhi company abhi tak nahi gaya hai, I want to know what companies are those, so that maybe there is something good that will come out now and I will invest. So take a look at that. That is a column U in the last sheet, sheet 1. So this is comprehensive data as much as there. Now, in addition to this data, if you feel like there is some other column or some other thing that will help you make a decision to filter out stocks for you and all, let me know. I can get it for you. That's not an issue. If you're not using financials, then this is the data. If you are using financials, you can probably get some more from, you know, any other data you want, I can get it for you, not an issue. Latest quarter, last two quarters, you want to see like that. There's a Q2 of 2021 versus Q2 of 2020 compare karna hai, mujhe YOY. Or QOQ bhi compare karna hai. If you want that also, I can give you. That's not an issue. So you decide which way you want to do it. But the end result should be that you should get a small universe of stocks, something not more than 200 to 250. That's it. Out of the 3,100 that are there, you should end up with something like 200 to 250. Say, ye mera investable universe rahega agle 6 mahine ya ek saal ke liye. You know, it could be for any reason why you want to invest in that. Large cap ho, small cap ho, pehle return nahi diya ho, abhi dega return. Ye sasta lag raha hai mujhe PE ke upar. नहीं ईपीएस इसका अच्छा है तो मैं इसके ले लूंगा. सो विच एवर रीजन यू हैव एंड विच एवर रीजन यू वॉन्ट टू टेक इट एंड योर स्ट्राइड एंड से ओके दिस इज द ऑन बेसिस ऑफ विच आई विल गो, प्लीज डू इट. आफ्टर यू डू इट पुट द 250. इन द 250 इफ यू वॉन्ट एनी स्पेसिफिक थिंग आई कैन गिव यू कि मुझे और थोड़ा इसके बारे में करना है, जैसा कुछ ब्रोकरेज का रिपोर्ट मिलेगा क्या ऐसा एंड ऑल दैट, वी कैन ऑल टुगेदर पुल अप एंड मेक द रिसोर्सेज, दैट्स नॉट एन इश्यू. दिस वे यू कैन डू. नाउ दिस इज फॉर इन्वेस्टिंग पर्पस. नाउ यू वॉन्ट टू डू फॉर स्विंग और पोजिशनल और वॉट एवर दैट यू कॉल, यू कैन स्टिल ट्राई फ्रॉम दिस डेटा. आई थिंक दिस इज प्लेंटी ऑफ डेटा टू ट्राई फॉर दैट. यस आई डोंट नो, आई एम आस्किंग पीपल, इज इट और नो? यूज होगा नहीं होगा? इतने माइक म्यूट में यार क्या चल रहा है ये?
सर आई थिंक वी कैन यूज दिस.
यू विल डू प्रॉब्ली मंथली स्विंग्स और समथिंग, नो? इफ आई मीन इफ यू वांट टू ट्राई समथिंग लाइक दैट.
यस सर.
इवन या द लास्ट शीट इज फॉर मंथली ओनली, द शीट नंबर 1. Monthly returns. You want to filter by that, check and take a call. You want to do by sector. Let us say you feel that ye sector acha chalega. Filter by sector and take it. As simple as that. In that sector, you want to do a specific industry, then check it out. Agri, textile, sab cover kiya hai isme. Anything that actually traded yesterday is here. If it's not traded, it is not here. Two days, I think it will make good use of your time to actually see is what I feel. Yes, no, maybe kuch karenge.
Yes. Sir, we'll go through this. I'm just actually, sorry, I'm just going through this and I'm just little bit stuck to reply.
No problem. What I mean to say is that, see, that the data will look overwhelming. Please understand.
Yes, yes sir.
Many of the people here are not used to seeing so many lines of data.
Yes.
Many times you look at very small sets of data and you feel like, okay, ye set mere liye theek hai. Now, itna dekha nahi hoga. But that is the reason why I'm telling you, you can't stay overwhelmed forever.
Right. We have to improve.
Market mein jitne stocks hai, utna aapko pata hona chahiye. Kam se kam naam, if not what business they do, you should have at least... Suppose somebody says the name of some stock, you should be able to tell, ye stock suna hai maine. So that way it would give you more, little more leeway,
right.
Running better.
Right.
That's what I feel. This is more, see, this is not just so that you can earn money off in tons and other things like that. This is an awareness exercise.
Right.
Which could result in you ending up in doing amazing investments or even trading, if it's possible, you can. It can work both ways. Now, yeah, please tell me.
No, sir. Continue. Sorry.
I'll tell you something. I'll show you. For people who are interested in which one? For investing purpose, let us say you have to take a call. What do you call this? You want to see this after you shortlist, you want some idea of like, see, ye company, how did it perform and all that. I can give you a sheet like this completely for Q2. Just check this sheet. I just posted the snapshot. So, sheet mil sakta hai. I can make it for you. I'll give you net sales, YOY net sales, QOQ net sales. I'll give you PAT, YOY PAT, QOQ PAT percentage. EPS TTM milega, current market price, P and PBV or whichever day you want. I mean, only one day. Like, aaj ne aapne sheet manga, to aaj ka date ka milega wo sab. Tomorrow, I can't give today's date. This changes every day, so it can't. Market cap is there, obviously. That is in millions, so don't be worried too much about it. This data of net sales, net profit, and market cap is in millions. That's why you see so many big numbers.
Mm-hmm. I was just going to say that, is this in crores or what?
No, it is in millions.
Okay.
It's some of those formatting things.
Right.
And can you repeat EPS and PE? No, nothing. See, what I'm telling is, if you are taking by financials, and if you see the sheet, again, the TTM PE, what is there is more or less the PE that you will see everywhere. So if you want to take by PE basis, ki ye sabta mujhe isme lagana hai, so you can try. Now, you can even do EPS calculation simple way. Udhar current market price hai na, just divide the current market price divide by PE. Right now, that is in the sheet. Ek minute, let me only tell you out. Huh. If you look at the third sheet, raw data, free to use wala sheet, na, current market price E divided by L should give you EPS anyway. Okay?
Any particular just generally any company we can do that one?
Any company can do. Now, the only thing is, if you want to take a little step further and say, I want to stay invested for March 2022 results tak. Last year, a company delivered 15% growth, or this company or AX company has the habit of delivering 15% growth regularly. So I expect it to be 15%. So what you do is take last year's PE and last year's EPS multiplied by 1.15. Okay? After you multiply by 1.15, you will get some number, right? That number you subtract from the H2 EPS of till now. H2 mil jayega na?
Yes.
H2 is Q1 plus Q2. H1 is Q1 plus Q2. So when you do that, whatever is the remaining number, you just check if it is possible to achieve or not. Aisa rahega sometimes ki, let us say a company has made 100 rupees as EPS last year. You expect a 15% growth. That means 115 that you expect it to go. So let us say based on the 115 EPS, its PE is right now, let us say 30. So you will say 115 into 30, that means ES stock 3450 tak ja sakta hai. Abhi 2800 hai, so it is looking undervalued for me. These are thumb rules, huh? Don't take it as like hard and fast rule. Easy calculations ke liye bol raha hu main.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So you can say 3450 tak ja sakta hai, abhi 2800 hai, that means there is scope. Agar utna bhi nahi aaya, tabhi thoda bahut EPS aaya, tabhi kam se kam 3100 tak ja sakta hai. That is the first inference you can make. Second inference to make, last year was 100, this year you expect 115. Now you have calculated H1 EPS, which is Q1 plus Q2, and found that this company has done only 40 rupees EPS till now. Okay? Now, 115 it is supposed to do as per your understanding, but it has done only 40 rupees. So, 75 karna hai Q3 or Q4 mila ke. Ho sakta hai ki nahi, you have to check. If it's not possible, probably the company will, be a little subdued, thoda kam rahega and all. A financial way, but see, you can always counter me by saying Tata Motors the negative EPS hai, toh aap kaise kar rahe? Ho jayega wo. See, don't take it as a hard and fast rule. I'm just telling thumb rules here. What is applicable for some companies cannot, again, all FNO stocks. Sorry, yeah.
I think that was like a one-off thing. We can't expect that in Tata Motors again for some time.
Tata Motors right now, its current trailing TTM EPS is minus 40.29. Last March, its EPS was minus 40.51. March 2020 was 39, minus 39. March 2019 was minus 99. Itka matlab, 3 saal se to EPS profit mein hi nahi hai. Par stock price 60 rupees se 500 gaya hai. Now, if you tell ye kaisa hua, I can't tell. Some exceptions you have to leave. Second thing is, based on what I have been observing, FNO stocks normally, even if they are negative or a little low on EPS, they don't seem to suffer so much. It's just a notice I've seen. They don't seem to suffer so much, really. PSU chodatum, but FNO stocks is because people also trade in futures and options. No? That's why the stock price remains at a different level altogether. Not what you would have perceived as like 3000 jayega ya 3150 jayega, वैसा नहीं है. तो टाटा मोटर्स फॉल्स इनटू दैट कैटेगरी, दैट्स व्हाई.
That does affect the current market price to some extent, right, sir? The FNO participation.
Correct. See, FNO stocks get change. How should you say? It's easy, no? Like, let us say all the people here today decide that tomorrow we will buy Tata Motor futures. Correct. So you can move, I mean, if you spend enough, you can probably move the stock a little, at least, definitely. So aisa ho jata hai wo. Now, see, why are people investing in Tata Motors means it is not about current. See, please understand, there are two parts to it. The result that you are looking right now at Tata Motors is a result that has already happened.
Correct.
Whereas the price that you are paying for is for what will happen in future. Same way, stock market and economy, stock market and GDP. Stock market is forward-looking, GDP is backward-looking. GDP is always laggard, no? GDP, correct, abhi September ka khatam ho gaya hai. Now, probably by November 30th, we will get the GDP number. Now, agar usko dekh ke khush hone se ya dukh hone se kuch farak nahi padta, because 2 months already ja chuke hai.
Correct. It's in the past.
Yeah, it's in the past. So, it doesn't matter. Same way, this is also like that. EPS of what you see right now for any company is as of September. So it is in the past. Whereas stock price is probably building for either December or March or next year March. Wohi hota hai na, FY22 EPS bolte wo log, FY22 PE pe trading kar raha hai. You've seen how brokerages right now, this stock, yes, is trading at an EPS, EPS of 20 with a
FY24 earnings. Correct. Always used to ask how that, why they say that thing.
Well, the same way, like I said, no, see, you have 100 rupees is last year. Your stock has been growing at a rate of 15% every year. Mm-hmm. So you multiply 100 into 1.15 to get FY22.
Correct. That should that be that.
That is what your thumb rule will say. Now, to that 115, you do another 1.15 to get FY23 number.
Correct.
Then 1.15 to get 24 number. So, that way you keep extrapolating. Now, this is a base case scenario. Another case, what you will do, how do you read it? This Palana company has agreed to put a capex of 1,000 crore, which will help it get a EPS, which will help it get a profit of somewhere around 50 crore, bola hai, samjho. So, you will add that net profit to this and see, okay, the growth from 2013 will not be only 15%, it will be 15 plus another 1.5% coming from this new one, new capex. So, that right. Year, you will now multiply by 1 plus, what do you call, instead of 15%, you will do by 16.5%, let us say, something like that. Then you will find that suddenly some company has gone for an acquisition and has taken over another company who is generating profit and it, right, is expected to add 5 rupees EPS for your company, let us say. So that 5 rupees EPS means, okay, 100 pe 5 rupees kitna hua, roughly around 5% ho gaya. So that 5% now you will add again.
Okay,
to that one. So you keep building. Ek base lagayega. 100 rupiya somewhere you started. Last year, 100 rupees is your base. On top of that, 15% is organic growth.
Correct.
On top of that, another 5% is capex growth. Due to capex that is coming. On top of that, some more coming due to acquisition. Like that, you keep adding and building for a particular year and then extrapolate it for the next years. That is how these are all done.
Correct.
So, that's how it is. Now, sometimes companies say, we will buy some company out in this year and we will try to grow to 25,000 crore in the next 3 years. So, let us say right now, they are somewhere around 18,000 crore. So, they are going to go to 25,000 crore. At the same EBITDA and same margin level, net profit level, if you look at it, okay, this is how EPS would be, you will check. So that EPS, without any re-rating of PE, if you multiply, you will get a rough price number. Okay, without any re-rating. Now, suppose if there is a re-rating, like it has happened in the case of IT companies in this year, 2021, mein, this calendar year. Earlier, IT companies were all trading at low PEs, right? Now they are all at higher PEs. Right. All of them got upgraded suddenly. So when this happens, it is an additional booster, that's all. But technically, you shouldn't look at PE rating. You should look at most of the time as your EPS growth, earnings growth.
The difference in the PE ratings, that is.
No, no, no. PE mein jo bhi hai rehne do. See, last year was 30 PE average, let us say. For next year also, you take it as 30 PE only. Don't add or subtract more. Okay? Right. The earnings which is there, that one you will do. Last year was 100 rupees. Okay, this year now it will be 15% growth, so 115. Now, to this 115 of your base thought process, there can be either addition or subtraction. For example, some company had a fire in their factory, or they had a maintenance due to which they had to be shut down for 1 month. So, one month, no production. Like semiconductor shortages, 60% of production is gone. Okay. So, this 60% gone. So, monthly they used to sell 1 lakh vehicles. Now, they will sell only 40,000 vehicles. So, they said that the production cut will be only applicable for 1 month. So, 40% of this month's production plus 100 of next month plus 100 of next month. That is how you will calculate.
Right.
So, everything is like, see, the reason why the target prices and all vary between different brokerages is because of the assumptions that go in there. Some people take different assumptions based on, like, some people are thinking that 15% growth is what I assume this to be. Some people think, no. This year, the demand is going to be higher. Mm-hmm. So, 18% growth is what I will factor in.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that is how it is. Then suddenly, everybody realizes that this sector fully is doing very well. So, iske liye PE re-rating karna chahiye. Jaisa realty sector ka re-rating hua hai. Realty sector, PEs used to be very, different earlier. But now everybody is like telling, okay, nahi, aur itna jayega, that's it. So then PE re-rating happens. That is where the difference comes in. Somebody decides, 30 PE chal raha tha iska, abhi main isko 33 deta hun. Koi bolta hai, nahi, main isko 35 dunga. So please understand, the difference between 33 and 35 PE can be so huge for some companies. Why? Because the 2 PE cut difference hai na, when you multiply that by EPS, agar chota EPS hai, 2 rupiah, 3 rupiah ka EPS hai, to 6 rupiah ka farak aayega bas. Par agar 250 rupiah ka EPS hai samjho us company ka.
Right.
So, 2 se multiply karoge, to 500 ho gaya udhar.
Correct.
So, those and all differences also keep coming up. So, that is why you find so much difference between people to people, between different brokerages and different analysts who are doing for the same sector also. So, whichever way you want to do, the first basic thing is to know if you know the stock name or not. Correct, Anna?
Right.
Naam to pata hona chahiye sab, kitne ko stock hai company isme. So, that is the reason why that sheet is there. This could be your starting point to see, and whenever there is a new IP or something that comes in, yes, it will be added again to the list. That is how it will come. But this is where you can start. Check the company, check the sector, check the industry, check the market cap, check the PE ratio where it is sitting. Understand what the stock price is right now, how low, how much has it fallen from its high, or how much has it risen from its low. Then see if it makes sense for you. Yes, ye sector mein mujhe interest hai, ye sector mein interest nahi hai. Then filter that out and then take it forward. After you take it forward, if you say, okay, I want to see the little more financials of this company, I'll give you QOQ, YOY, net profit, net sales, all I will give you, that numbers. In fact, even if you want, I can probably give you in some time. I was working on it only, so I can give you that information also. Any questions on the sheet part or exact kya karna hai uske saath?
We'll have to go through this little bit in more details around.
No, you have 2 days. What I'm telling is,
right,
kya karna hai, aap soch lijiye. But kya karna hai usko pata bhi nahi hai, means I can explain now. That's what I explained also now.
Correct.
That these numbers, you shouldn't get overwhelmed by seeing, itne numbers hai, main kya karunga. No, that might not work.
Ruchi Soya has also made it to your list, sir. I'm just going through it.
No. I just put every company, irrespective of how much it is priced or where it is sitting. As right. long as it has traded yesterday, its name right. is there.
Right.
That's how I've tried to put it. So that kam se kam company ka naam to pata chalega. So there are how many? 3145 total BSE list. I've put that out as much as possible. Taken.
Raw one is huge. I think this is going till 3000. My computer is actually lagging. So.
No. All the sheets have same 3145 only. All the sheets have.
Okay.
The first raw data, the only thing is only for your safety, I just put a lock sheet on that. That's it.
Right.
The second sheet also has 3145, but it is filtered to positive returns on YTD, 1 year, 2 year, 3 years. That's it.
Right.
Rest all remains same. The third sheet is completely, again, the 3145 free for you. You can use the whichever way you want. You can filter kuch bhi kar sakte ho. The fourth one that you see, sheet one, is specifically for month-wise returns of this year I have given for all the 3145 companies. So that you can see, ye saal mein kaise kiya, in this, how many months have gone by? Eight months. Plus, last 1 year mein kya kiya us stock ne? Plus, March 2020 se kya kiya usne?
Right.
So that you can see everything. For that purpose only, I gave that last sheet. Aage jayega, nahi jayega, chart achha hai, chart achha nahi hai. You can check all that also.
Correct. Very detailed sheet.
अवेयरनेस के लिए इधर से ही चालू करना पड़ेगा. कम से चालू करने से कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता. सपोज इफ आई गिव ओनली फॉर वन सेक्टर, द प्रॉब्लम इज समबडी एल्स विल से नहीं, ये सेक्टर के बारे में मुझे पता नहीं, मुझे दूसरा सेक्टर चाहिए.
करेक्ट.
सो दैट्स व्हाई आई कवर्ड एवरी सेक्टर, सो दैट पीपल हु आर इंटरेस्टेड इन स्पेसिफिक सेक्टर्स कैन टेक दोज ओनली. फॉर एग्जांपल, समबडी हु वांट्स टेक ओनली फार्मा कैन टेक फार्मा फ्रॉम हियर.
करेक्ट.
Any questions, anything? बस इतना ही था.
ये P slash B ratio क्या होता है? P ratio तो समझ में आया.
किसके लिए? किधर है?
सर P slash B ratio, ये भी बहुत websites में.
Price to book ratio.
That is price to book value.
उसका मतलब?
How should I tell you? See, you know, a company has total assets, right? Some assets, right? Assets.
Yes.
Then there are liabilities of the company, correct?
Yes.
Liabilities, money, what it owes to other people.
Loans, expenses.
Everything included, okay? Now, it is total assets minus total liabilities. Okay.
Samjha.
Okay, let me put it this way. You know the formula A is equal to L plus E, where assets. A is assets, L is liabilities, and E is equity, which is shareholders' equity. Correct?
How?
So now bringing L to this side, you will get A minus L is equal to E, correct?
A minus L. Haan, equity nikal jayega.
Equity. When liability comes to this side, it is A minus L. Udhar rahega E, correct? So that means shareholders' equity is equal to assets minus liabilities. That is called net worth.
Samjha.
So if you take the market cap of the company and divide it by the net worth, you will get P to BV, price to book value.
Samjha.
Okay, price to book value is that. And price to book value is a much better measure than PE, because again, like we discussed, for Tata Motors, the earnings is negative.
Yes.
Whereas price is positive. So your PE ratio for Tata Motors will be negative, correct?
Yes.
That's how it is. Technically, negative means usme to zero dikhai dega. PE minus 37 aisa thodi dikhayega. Nahi na?
Nahi.
Zero dikhana chahiye. Because it has no meaning actually. But on price to book value, it has meaning. If your book value is negative, then that means there is a real problem with the company. That means its reserves and shareholders' equity has gone off into the negative. That means it has been in losses so much that it has used up all its reserve money.
समझा तो सर जैसे मार्केट कैप है वो हमारा एसेट्स को लायबिलिटी से माइनस करने से मार्केट कैप फाइंड आउट हुआ
नो 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 एसेट्स माइनस लायबिलिटीज इज इक्विटी मार्केट कैप ओके लेट मी टेल मार्केट कैप इज इक्वल टू करंट मार्केट प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर इनटू टोटल नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स आउटस्टैंडिंग
समझा
Okay, market cap is equal to current market price into total number of shares outstanding. So, if total number of outstanding shares are same for any for two companies, let us say, so market cap is directly proportional to what current market price ho gaya na? That means price badega, to market cap badega. So, price is based on perception, correct?
Yes.
You think 500 rupees is valid for it, somebody else think nahi 50 rupees ke liye zyada hai. Now, when you find this discrepancy of between two companies in the same sector, you then go and find out about that chota price wala company. Is it low priced because of poor financials or is it low priced because people are not estimating it correctly? And when you read about that company and you find it that it has good growth prospects, but people are unable to perceive its value right now, then you go and buy that company. Simple. That is how people call bolte rehte na undervalued company dhundo, undervalued company. Right. Undervalued is that only. It is in relation with somebody else. No company by its say on itself you can say it is undervalued or overvalued. Correct, na?
Yes.
It is all relative, right? Yes, no?
Yes. So market jo value.
हाँ, correct. See, like for example, Sharma ji ka ladka hai, Verma ji ka ladka hai. Now Sharma ji ke ladke ke paas 90 aa raha hai har baar. अब शर्मा जी का लड़का शर्मा जी बोलते हैं मेरा लड़के को 90 आ रहा है बस अच्छा चल रहा है सडनली वर्मा जी लाइन में आ गए उन्होंने बोला नहीं नहीं मेरा लड़के का तो 98 आ रहा है अब स्टार्टिंग में सोच रहे कि 8 मार्क कम है उससे है कि नहीं बिकॉज इट इज रिलेटिव टू समबडी दैट इज व्हाई यू शुड ऑलवेज डू पीयर कंपैरिजन ऑन अ स्टैंड अलोन बेसिस व्हाट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इज द बिजनेस प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स एंड ऑल दैट इज ग्रेट फाइन बट व्हेन यू वांट टू सी द फाइनेंशियल्स यू हैव टू ऑलवेज डू अ पीयर कंपैरिजन That's much more easier and faster. Okay?